Hello and welcome back to another episode of FSM. Today you join me to open up my FUT Champions Weekend League rewards. Unfortunately I did record this live and my video got corrupted for the first part, which is very unfortunate. As you can see I'm opening up my two red packs right away and I get an okay choice. I'm going to take the Atletico Madrid man Partey. His card is all round solid. I'm going to use him as a super sub because, you know, for the Weekend League I brought on Paulinho in place for Wijnaldum. I found that I run my midfielders into the ground and Wijnaldum was the first one to run out of stamina, so having a super sub like Partey to come on who's an all-round beast is going to be super helpful. Moving into the second red pick, I'm hoping here, I was really hoping for Andy Robertson to go in at left back. At the moment, well, over the Weekend League, the left back was the position of weakness for me. I did have Benjamin Mendy, but he just seemed a bit clumsy. His defending wasn't fantastic, so I was really hoping, hence the pause, but I end up not getting Andy Robertson and I end up taking Szczesny. I did consider taking Rondon, but Szczesny's 87 rated. I believe he was the third highest rated player out of the whole team of the week, which I need to be count my luck for because he's high rated. I could chuck him into SBC later on down the line, and he's a good keeper. I mean, if I ever go into Serie A, I can get the likes of Bonucci or Chiellini or Benatia, chuck them at centre back, and I've got a very good goalkeeper to back them up. And obviously, the whole Serie A team in general is just a decent squad if you can afford the players, which I might go into hybrid to get the left back position sorted. As I said just now, the Mendy wasn't fantastic. Getting someone like Alexandre at left back would be the dream, really. So here I'm opening up the rest of my packs that I got for my FUT Rivals Awards and also the FUT Champions Awards. This one here was the two-player Champions League pack, and my rare Champions League player turned out to be Dusan Tadic, and then my non-rare was Farman, who was 84 rated. Both of them sold for about 7k, which is very useful. And then I jump into my normal packs now. I was hoping for something to boost my coins, and there you go, straight away, packing in form. He wasn't worth much. He was only 82 rated, I believe, and he's Hector. He was only worth about 15k, but basically I traded him in, bought another inform for 15k and put him into the Marcos Alonso SBC, which you'll be seeing very shortly. And the rest of the players I've either put up for sale or I used them in the SBCs, which you'll see in a minute. So open up to my next pack now. You've got the really bad goalkeeper I've never seen before in this game, and all round a bad pack, had a few squad fitness in there which was useful. And then the rare mega pack is coming up now, and this is where I saw the walkout and I thought, oh my god, this could be huge, like this is, could be amazing. Balls come down, I see the flag, I'm thinking goalkeeper, it's gonna be Oblak, but no, it's Handanovic. I'm never going to complain of a walkout, 88 rated walkout, just because of his rating he's worth quite a lot. So I sold him straight away. I needed to get the coins. I wanted to get the coins for the Marcos Alonso SBC, which you will see me doing right now. As you see, the rest of the pack was pretty trash, apart from one inform who was worth this card. So, jump into the SBCs now and see how it goes.
So, after doing the Marcos Alonso SBC, the first part, which is the expensive part, which gives me the 100k pack, you can see here I have completed it now. I used it, an untradeable goalkeeper inform I had. And I also bought this left back in form for the chemistry, and I was trading the Hector that I packed just now. And you can see there, it ended up pretty good, being pretty cheap. It's about average for what this should have cost. So I'm going to submit this, get the 100k pack in the bag. And then this second part, I don't want to go to the store just yet. The second part requires three rare UEFA Champions League cards, which is really annoying because at the moment they've all skyrocketed because of this SBC and because of other SBCs that require them. So I went ahead and I did this SBC, which is gives me three UEFA Champions League players, but only one of them is rare. However, they are all tradable, so gives me a little bit of extra coins. Only cost me, I reckon, about 2k to this, because all of these I just packed. So yes, I could have saved, gotten a bit of money, but I packed them anyway, so it means I got them pretty cheap. So I'm going to submit this and open up this pack and see if I need the 100k pack to fund me to do the rest of the Marcos Alonso SBC or not. So hopefully I get something pretty decent from this UEFA Champions League player pack. So I'm going to go straight into the store and open this up and see if it can help me complete the SBC. You see I'm on 80k, which means I should be able to just about do the second half of the Marcos Alonso SBC, but you never know. You literally never know. So we're going to jump in now. Let's do this. Let's hope for the best. Come on. Please be nice. Be nice to me. So it's not a walkout. Hoping for some high rated at least for rare. That's going to be Nani Keita, I believe. Okay, 84 rated, Premier League, rare, Champions League card. I'll take it. It's not bad. It's not a walkout, but 84 rated, I cannot complain. He'll probably go straight into my SBC, so I can link him up easily with Premier League. The other two are a bit shit, not going to lie. They're probably not going to be worth anything, so he's worth about 2k. This guy's going to be worth less than 1,000. So I'll keep this guy just because in case in the future he needs Champions League cards for some reason. And I'll also keep Naby Keita and see if I can use him. So I'm going to get back to you. Hopefully I'm able to get this done in less than 80k and I'll be able to open up the 100k pack and the mega pack and also get Marcos Alonso. I'll be right back. So after trying way too hard and for trying way too long to try and get this as cheap as I possibly can, I ended up with this team. It's not as cheap as it can be, to be honest. I ended up getting really annoyed because I misread the requirements, I did this, did that, did this, couldn't get a hold of Champions League players, everything was going wrong, I couldn't be bothered at the end. So I just bought Saul for more than what I probably should have done, and I just chucked him in the team, and now it works. So I got the requirements, I got the 84 rating, I got over 85 chemistry, so let's get this mega pack. This now means that I will have the Marcos Alonso. So I get the mega pack, I've got the 100k pack waiting for me in the store, and I've also just got the Marcos Alonso, as you can see on the screen now. His card looks okay, with a shadow he'll be pretty decent. It's just the upgrades, when they get through the group stage, you've got 85 rating, you get plus one over everything. I'm hoping Chelsea will go a little bit further than most. And you can see here now, he's about to walk out for us, and I'm hoping it's been a pretty good card. He'll be better than Mendy for sure. Mendy for me was incredibly clumsy. He just wasn't agile enough. His tackling was bad. Just wasn't ideal for me in terms of a left back that I wanted. So Marcos Alonso will have the strength that I want. The pace isn't all that important anyway. So I'm going to keep him, put him straight in my team. And let's open up those two packs that I have. So I've got a 100k pack waiting for me and a 35k pack. Mega pack. I'm going to go with a mega pack first. It's 30 items, 18 rare. Hope to get some of my money back because that SBC cost me around about 140,000 coins, maybe a little bit less. But I'm hoping to get some coins back because I've also got Marcos Alonso, who I'd say is worth about that anyway. So it's not a walkout. So let's hope for some boards. We do get boards, which is a good sign. Spanish goalkeeper, so that'd be Pepe Reina, who I just used. And he's worth absolutely nothing. Brilliant. So he's worth absolute jack shit. He's worth about 1700 coins, if that. And the rest of this pack is absolute trash. You got Matip in there. Nothing useful. Squad fitnesses, which is actually quite useful. Left wing to the forward might be worth a little something. But nothing, unfortunately, of note. So send it all to club. And here comes the big one. This is a 100k pack. These are incredibly rare. You don't get these. Over the last previous FIFAs, the only time you ever got these were through really big SBCs and or draft final wins, which were rare anyway. Like to get that as a reward on draft final wins. So, here we go. It's time. Let's do this. 100k pack. Getting a bit slightly nervous. I'm hoping to get something. So it's not a walkout. It's got to be boards though. It's a 100k pack. There we go. So that could be Mandzukic, who, as I was looking at just now, is the cheapest 84 rated player on the market at the moment. That is not a good 100k pack. 84 rated, there could be more 84s in here, but that's not a good start. It's not a good pack. Oh, that makes me sad. That's really, really, really not a good pack to open up to. Oh, I get another Pepe Reina. How fantastic is that? Okay, well, after a very, very poor couple of packs, I now have Marcos Alonso, which is a good thing. I'll be going into a few games, try to get used to using him, put a shadow card on him, because that's what he'll definitely need. Sell all these players, see what I can get. So, join me next time, probably next week, when I'll be playing a few rivals games. I won't be playing weekend league this weekend. I'm a bit busy, so next week, learn how to play with the team, and I'll catch you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.